Hi everyone, welcome back to Wild Adventures. Today, we are going to talk about defect check. We will first go through the things to bring for the defect check and what to look out for. Next, we will go through what are some of the major and minor defects we have found in our flat. Watch till the end for our bonus content on the HDB key collection preparation. Here are the things to bring for defect check. A bucket or pail for holding the water to test the drainage or water bonding. A rag to differentiate whether there is any stain or it is actually just dust. Pen and masking tape to tag and label the defects so that the BSC contractors can come in to rectify them. We had tried using post-it, but we couldn't overcome the emotional fear of the post-it flying away from the actual location, so we stick to using masking tape instead. Multi-adapter socket with light, or anything with light indication to check all the electrical sockets. We feel that it is faster to switch on and see the light than connecting to handphone charger to check the sockets. Dental mirror or the handphone front camera, if only you can maneuver the handphone at really tight space. This is to check for the hard to see places and it's also for the screws on the window frame. Screwdriver to open the water main. We'll be showing later on how to open the main. A leveler to check the sloping of the tiles. For flat ground, the air bubble should be in the middle. For wet areas, the air bubble should be further away from the drainage point. Coins to check the sound of the tiles. We will also explain this later. Door stoppers. Please buy the largest possible ones that you can find in the market if you didn't opt for any flooring. We had to stack two together to stop our main door from sliding. Number lock so that the BSC contractors can come in and rectify the defects when you are not around. Here are some of the optional items for your comfort. Water, S-hook, charger, light, measuring tape, and mask for the huge amount of dust. Now, let's turn on the water main before we check the defects. If you are liking the content, a sub to our channel will be spectacular! Next, we will go through what are the typical things to check for. For a detailed checklist, refer to the document link in our description. We use it for our defect check. Credits to RenoNation for developing such a comprehensive checklist. We separated them into 6 areas. Firstly, the doors and the gates. We check for rusty hinges or handles, scratches on the door, whether the key collected at the HDB can open and lock the door properly, and whether the door and gate opening is smooth or is there any screeching sounds. Second, the windows. Similarly, we check for the rust, smoothness in opening and closing, and whether they can be locked properly. Additionally, do check for any cracks on the window glass and the rubber ceiling, and also use the dental mirror or the front camera to check if there's any missing screws. Next up, the walls and flooring. For the wall, please check for water stain mark, cracks or peeling. For the floor, it is mainly about whether it is even. For the tiles, we check each tile using a coin to see if there's hollow tiles. There might be differences in sound such as this. We realize that this difference might be due to it being a structural wall or normal wall. You might want to weigh the pros and cons before reporting to BSC. Tiles rectification might take some time and it will potentially delay your renovation. But if you are going to put heavy things or you found hollow floor tiles, it may be worthwhile to rectify this as it may have safety concerns. For electrical defects, we check for defective or damaged socket by testing each socket. We also check if the circuit breaker is working by closing the breaker and oning the switch. Next, check all the taps for the water flow and also the toilet flush. We find that generally the water flow is weak as HDB had installed the PUB water saving device in the fittings. We also play around with water to check for the drainage speed and if there's any water bonding on the ground. Lastly, some miscellaneous checks include faulty letterbox key, difficulty in rising and lowering the Makita laundry rack, and if there's any rust around the drying rack. Comment down below if you have faced similar kind of defects or other horrible stories. Here are some of the major defects we have faced that may affect the functionalities. We have scratches and rust on our main gate and the hinges. They sanded it and spray painted it to rectify the issue. We have multiple scratches, rust, and dents on our main door and bedroom door. The peek hole on our main door was slanted and was not able to close properly. There were some sort of paint marks on the screws for the window locking mechanism. If you compare with the picture on the right, you can see that there's no such mark. We found this for the bottom screws for all the window locking mechanism. We found a cheap towel under the sink in our master bedroom toilet. There's two ways for the BSC to rectify them, is to remove the fitting and replace the entire towel, or just use compound paste to cover up. We chose to use the compound paste as we are going to overlay it with tiles and we do not want to further delay the start of the renovation. But if you want to replace the tiles, do expect longer rectification timeline. We also found our household shelter grout were not done properly with some peeling off or missing grout. We also have these minor defects which were cosmetic. We found some peeling, bumpy paint spots and scratches on our main gate. There's also some spray paint marks on the outside wall. On our main door, there's many paint marks on the laminate and some unknown white patches. There's also some black color mark on the household sheltered door and some paint drip mark on the wall. Thanks for staying with us until the end. Here is our bonus content. Things to bring for key collection when you receive the key collection date SMS and the email. Working SingPass and two-factor authentication. Open a new SP Utilities account so that you can have water and electricity during your key collection. Apply for the fire insurance via online if you are taking the HDB loan. And you can also choose to add in the home insurance for your home contents. Do prepare the power of attorney if you or your partner is unable to attend on the key collection day. This is the end of our video. Please like, share and subscribe to our channel to follow our renovation adventure. If you have missed our first video on key collection, you can click the link over here. Stay tuned for our next video on our renovation update.